James, how many?
Super dodgy 8.
Super dodgy 8. Okay, Louise?
6.
Okay, what's the 6?
Shames.
Shames, okay. Could be good enough. Let's hear for the super dodgy 8 that James has got.
Foamless.
Yes, you can have foamless sofas, I guess. Foamless cushions. It's in the dictionary. Well done.
Very good.
Well done.
Wow.
Well done.
I've got a sponge front door. Hey, don't knock it. We've got another word here, haven't we? Another 7. Not as good as foamless, but we've got flashes.
Yes.
Yeah.
Very good. James is showing flashes of brilliance at the moment. He has 44. Louise has 27. Still somewhere to go, though. Just about halfway. Here's the next letters round. James.
Vowel, please, Rachel.
Thank you. Start with U.
Another one.
E.
Another one.
O.
Consonant.
T.
Another one.
R.
Another one.
Another R.
Another one.
D.
Vowel.
I.
And a consonant, please.
And to finish, a third R.
And here's the countdown clock. Louise, what have you got?
Just a 6.
And James?
Yeah, just 6.
OK. James, what's your 6?
Terror.
And yours, Louise?
Yeah, I've got the same word.
Yep. I'll ask you, torrider? Can you have something that's more torrid?
No, it's not actually. It would have to be specified because it's got more than one syllable and it's not in.
That's what I thought.
But nice try.
So what is in?
Outrider.
Yes, an outrider, somebody who escorts people in a sort of armed situation, or horses in a horse race in America, an outrider.
Do you ever get that one? Yeah. Well done, children. Do you ever get that when you're halfway through eating a horse and you think to yourself, I'm not as hungry as I thought I was?
James 50, Louise 33, by no means over, but it is for a few moments because our contestants can just take a little break. It's Origins of Words time again with Susie. We've been looking at sort of humorous origins, haven't we,
yes, in the last couple of days? Yes, all in honour of Tim, but I don't mean this one personally. I was going to talk about cheese, because I was thinking, why jokes thought of as being cheesy, or some jokes, not yours.
Thank you.
And there's so many expressions involving cheese. You can be cheesed off, you can have a cheesy grin, and that goes right back to playground slang. Cheese meant a smile right in the 1930s.
You can eat it as well,
you can eat cheese. Yeah. Or something can be cheesy, and that's all about the unhappy habit that ripe cheese has of letting its presence be known through smell. But then I thought about big cheese. Where does big cheese come from? And that one's quite interesting, because it's the only positive sense of cheese in slang that's ever existed, it seems. And originally it had nothing to do with cheese at all. It comes from a Persian or a Hindi word, chiz, C-H-I-Z, which meant the thing. And during the Indian Empire, Anglo-Indians would say, it's the real chiz, meaning it's the real thing. And of course, when people came back to Britain, nobody knew what a chiz was, so they changed it to cheese.
Yes.
So they would say it's the real cheese. And the big cheese developed in 20th century America, at the beginning of the 20th century. And they had lots of big things. They'd say big bug, big potato, big fish, big toad. And of course, we talked about big wig. And it was just another in a long line of big terms of approval. And big cheese isn't usually very complimentary. It's usually something a little bit derisory. And the latest, apparently, are big enchiladas and big bananas in America, but I quite like the big cheese story.
What does that mean? Maybe that just what's
no,
big
maybe
enchiladas?
We won't think about that. Well, instead of saying the big cheese, they say it's the big enchilada.
Oh, I see what you mean. Right, okay, it means the same thing. Yeah. I recently bought some Armageddon cheese, and on the packet it said best before end.
Well, in terms of this countdown contest, James is the big cheese at the moment. He's the one with a cheesy grin, and Louise is a little cheesed off. But all that could soon change, because it's time for our next numbers round. And Louise, it's your selection.
Can I have one big one and 5 small, please, Rachel?
Traditional one from the top and 5 little ones. Thanks, Louise. For the second round, we've got 9, 8, 6, 5, 7, and the large one, 100. And the target, 291.
And you have 30 seconds to reach that target. Well, both put their pens down within the first 10 seconds or so. Louise?
291.
James?
291.
Louise, let's have your version.
8 minus 5 is 3.
8 minus 5 is 3.
Times 100.
Times 100.
And then -9.
And -9. Very nice.
Yeah, same method. Well done to both of you. James has 60. Louise has 43, so it's still in the balance. Here's another teaser for you. The words are what soup, what soup. And the clue, you're right if you think he's left. You're right if you think he's left. See you shortly. Yes, you're right if you think he's left. Southpaw, boxing terminology, of course. Southpaw is the answer. No knockout blow landed in this contest so far. James has 60, but Louis is still in there with 43. Here's our next letters round. It's James to pick.
Vowel, please, Rachel.
Thank you. Start with E.
Another one.
A.
Another one.
I.
Consonant.
N.
Another one.
S.
Another one.
R.
Another one.
G.
Another one.
V.
And a final consonant, please.
And a final T.
And your 30 seconds starts now. Now, Louise, how many?
8.
And James?
8.
OK, what's your 8, James?
Starving.
Starving. Yeah, Louise?
Exactly what I've got as well.
Yep, fantastic. Well done. Hard to beat or even match.
Yes, well, we've got averting, didn't we, Susie?
We did. And
what are you looking at?
There is a 9, actually.
Go on, is
there? There is a 9, a late 9.
Yes.
Well, vintages was there for 8, but if you put an R in it and have vintagers, they are people who harvest grapes.
Yeah. And there's an 8 as well, isn't there?
Yes. Was
vinegars.
Vinegars, nice one.
I went to a supermarket. I said, this vinegar's got lumps in it. He said, those are pickled onions.
James 68, Louise 51. Here's our next letters round. Louise, it's your choice.
Consonant.
Thank you, Louise. R.
And another one, please.
L.
And another.
T.
And another one.
N.
And a vowel.
A.
And another one.
O.
Another vowel, please.
E.
A consonant.
B.
And another vowel, please.
And the last one, O.
Here's the countdown clock. James, how many?
7.
Louise?
I'll risk a 7 then.
Okay, what's your risky 7?
Bloater.
Bloater.
That's what I've got.
Same one.